An historic night regionally. Kevin Riggs of our staff is in San Diego with Republicans tonight, and we're going to start by looking at Proposition 93, which is a California proposition about term limits. Kevin?
That's right. Things obviously picking up here at GOP headquarters in San Diego at the Westcott Hotel with the polls closed. Matt Romney, Governor Mitt Romney's son, arrived just a few minutes ago and was surrounded by a lot of cameras. But as you mentioned, another very important issue on the ballot today, Prop 93, which would change California's term limits law. Steve Poizner is the state insurance commissioner. He also has taken on the role as really spearheading this effort to defeat Prop 93, put a lot of his own personal money behind it. Interesting that the early polls showed that Republicans were inclined to support Prop 93 because they saw that it would reduce the overall time in office from 14 to 12 years, but then later absentee votes were going the other way. The fact that there's a lot of late absentee votes this time around, how do you think it may make a difference here?
Well, my whole challenge as the chair on the No on 93 campaign was just to educate voters, Republicans, Democrats, and Independents alike, that 93 was being marketed in a very deceiving way. People were totally confused. They thought 93 would actually shorten terms, when in fact, if you read all the fine print, it will lengthen terms a lot. In fact, 42 termed out legislators get to stay in office, some for up to 20 years if 93 passes. So over the last month, we've educated voters. Support for 93 has plummeted, and yesterday's field poll showed support for 93 down to 33%. So I feel pretty good that we're able to communicate our message out there.
There have not been any exit polling on the 93, so at this point it's all just anecdotal?
Well, it's just mainly yesterday's field poll, nice and fresh, you know, from a statewide poll there, where it was a couple months ago at 60% support, now down to 33% support. So we've had a large effort on the No on 93 side to get the word out through television stations, radio stations, editorial boards. We've been outspent over 2.5 to 1, but we still had enough critical mass to get that message out.
You said recently that you had received some threats from the Democratic leadership over your involvement in this particular campaign.
Well, I am insurance commissioner. I have 1,300 employees, and they have control over my budget. And you know that the Speaker of the Assembly and the head of the Senate, they both term out in 2008. If Prop 93 passes, they get to stay in power for many more years. So the stakes are very high. So in the heat of battle, some things that were said that they probably shouldn't have said. But in any case, persevered on, and we fought hard, and I'm pretty comfortable we're going to win tonight. And then the state and the leadership in Sacramento needs to get back to business.
What about the criticism that you were latching onto this issue, basically to further your own ambitions as far as wanting to run for governor?
Well, you know, there's been a lot of speculation about my running for governor, and of course the yes side tried to slow me down by saying I had, you know, various motives. But let me just say that I won't let all that speculation about what I might do in the future stop me from doing the right thing now. The fact is, I'm only one of 8 elected statewide officers in California, and I'm not going to sit on the sidelines and watch this power grab go on. Prop 93 is a naked power grab by a bunch of termed out politicians to stay in power for a longer period of time, and I had to step up and say something.
We'll see what the voters say tonight. Mr. Poizner, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Steve Poizner, the state insurance commissioner, again spearheading the No on 93 campaign. Obviously, the polls just closed. We don't know the outcome yet, but we will be watching the results here throughout the night, as well as results in that presidential race. Dave Lois, back to you.
And should 93 go down to defeat, it's going to be interesting to see the mad scramble for legislative leadership.